Adobe just released a free upgrade for its B2B edition for Adobe Commerce, aka Magento 2. While there's several amazing features, one of them being quote templates, I'm going to give you the inside scoop on the most impactful feature of all of them. One that I've actually seen a company walk away from the most powerful B2B suite on the market because this feature was missing. And it is Company Hierarchies. In this video, I will walk you through use cases, give you a brief demo, discuss its limitations, and present a plan for upgrading. Let's jump in. But before we take a look at this.
Okay, here it comes.
If you need help with this upgrade or even understanding how these features would be integrated into your business processes, I'd love to introduce you to one of our solutions consultants. They're incredibly talented previous merchants who understand how this e-commerce technology maps to your unique requirements. I digress. Let's jump in. Before we start talking about hierarchies, there is a new foundational feature that enables these hierarchies to be usable, and that is that customers can now be assigned to multiple companies. Users can switch from one company account over to another account simply by using a drop-down menu, similar to switching currencies, languages, or store views. But onto the real feature. Companies can be arranged, and as you probably have guessed, in a parent-child hierarchy. Yes, it is only one level deep, but then again, this is Magento, so anything is possible. The cool thing is, this capability opens the door for a truly enterprise-grade management plan for your customers, something in this B2B space that they definitely want. But let's talk about the benefits. Number one, this provides a model that matches the needs for many enterprise level customers. You know, it allows these customers to segment out, well, number two, into these different entities so that they can be all managed under one umbrella. This is a big deal for many corporations where the basic Magento product just had no, even the B2B edition had no idea about how this would work. Those days are now over. Number three. This can also leverage unique shared catalogs per company. Think about this in the case of a franchise organization. I'll use the massive example of McDonald's, but we have a parent organization, and maybe there's some unique requirements for each one of the franchises, depending on maybe their location in the country, maybe different shipping costs, etc. And these shared catalogs can be used to present different offerings per each franchisee in this case. And number four, it is a great foundation for future capabilities. As I said earlier, it is in no way, shape, or form a complete system that accommodates all businesses' needs across the board, but this is Magento, so you can build on it. For example, maybe you have corporate needing to place orders on behalf of a sub company. Very possible to do given the structure that has already been built out. But as I said earlier in this conversation, I would be remiss to not share with you some of the limitations. These limitations are only as much as there is a lack of budget to implement them. Of course, any one of these can be overcome with some additional development time to get around this. Let's talk about the big one first. And that is that parent account users don't cascade to child companies. So we have a user in a parent account, and that user is unable to access the child account records or anything about that. They're basically two separate companies. So this has several obvious limitations. First is that the parent company users cannot see child account orders or users. These accounts are entirely autonomous. They're separate from each other. And so you might say that the hierarchy is present in idea, but not much past that. Number two, administrators would also have to create separate accounts in order to own or have ownership over these child company accounts. So each account has to have a unique company administrator. That's who controls everything that happens, kind of like this god user of a company account. Since it has to be a unique user, you can't really share these company administrators across multiple accounts, or if you can, it's kind of a really obtuse process to do that. Each account would theoretically have to have its own unique company administrator, which makes management a royal pain. Otherwise, if that doesn't happen, if a child account or child company signs up for their own account and then the relationship is made in the admin, which we'll talk about here in a second, well, then that child company or that franchisee owns the relationship and could ultimately kick the corporate account out. website administrators need to make company level assignments. Number two, administrators would have to create separate accounts to own their sub company accounts. So basically, each company has its own unique administrator. When a new company is created, it has to have a new administrator account. Maybe kind of possible, but the process would be super obtuse working in the database to make that happen. By not having that, it just complicates administration of these accounts quite significantly. Basically, a user has to be added into every single one of those child accounts in order to maintain ownership of it. There's some ways to get around this, but overall, it's a bit painful to work through. Number three, website administrators need to make the child company assignments themselves in the admin panel. In other words, your sales team is responsible for associating a parent company with a child company or the main umbrella organization with the sub accounts underneath it. This is not something that people can do on the front end. We've talked about the benefits. We've talked about limitations. Let's talk about some use cases. And the first one is a huge win, I think, overall. And that is franchises. If you have a company set up where your customers, you have an umbrella, and then you are selling to the customers underneath this umbrella, that's what this is designed for. Huge win, because each store can now have their own account, and you could theoretically create their own catalog of products for each account. You probably would not want to do that and would want to group by perhaps region if possible. But the cool thing is here, you now have a central reference point even in the database that brings this under one roof. And yeah, before this upgrade, it would definitely not have been possible. But number two, again, appealing to this enterprise B2B space would be large corporate customers with divisions that may be also separately using your products. This would also apply to buyers, perhaps under a private equity umbrella as well. And number three, and this goes into what we're going to talk about here in a few minutes as far as how to migrate or how to upgrade here, but also this would be for your internal management. Perhaps you have relevant companies and just want to apply better reporting. Even though your customers are not asking for this capability immediately, this is something that you would like to start leveraging yourself as perhaps in your integration with your CRM to enrich some of that data, applying multiple companies for one user at a time. All of this might sound great, but I suggest we jump into a demo to understand how this will all work out in real time. So join me. All right, so we have a couple of companies here under our demo environment. I have access to all of them, so that's why you see my similar email addresses for each one of those. This is the OG account right here, the Swift Otter account. And you can see this grid looks functionally the same, but there are two new columns that we can see over here on this side, and that is company type and parent. So we can see whether it's a parent or a child. Again, this goes back to the conversation that there is one level deep on this hierarchy. We have a parent, then we have a child. Let's look at the parent here real quick. We'll come over here, click edit. Drop down here. This tab is new on this page. We have a company hierarchy and we can assign additional companies into this. So we see we're working at Swift Otter, and somehow Walmart is a subdivision of Swift Otter. And each one of them can have properties that are assigned, that are configured here by just clicking on the edit, and it drops us into the child company account. I'm going to click back here. We can take a look. We can also change company settings, which is pretty nice, because let's say we have five franchises and we want to change a few settings at that level. We can set, for example, their customer group, i.e. shared catalog, for each one of them all at one time. It will make Well, it is a bit of a time savings here to do this. These other fields will also be helpful if you're going to want to release a new shipping method out to these different companies. Very possible to do that. So pretty basic changes, updates here, but knowing how they work will be highly beneficial. One thing to note is we now have this company name column, which indicates whether it is a parent or a child and how that hierarchy works together. We can pull in multiple other companies here. Well, actually we cannot, because all companies have been assigned out as parents or children in this case. So they cannot be then pulled in. Continuing on, how do we assign a customer then to a company? Well, this is fairly similar to the way it used to work, but we're going to jump over here into this customer panel here and click all customers. And in my example here for my main user as Joseph B2B can say it is associated to company. This is where this multiple company feature comes in. So in order for me to access or utilize the Walmart company underneath Swift Otter, I would then need to be associated to this company manually. This is something that I have to do as a store administrator. A customer cannot do this. This is an important variable that it's easy to miss, can cause some frustration in there. It's a powerful new feature, but the way this works out on the front end is slightly unrefined. And it gives the opportunity for you as a administrator of a Magento website to flesh out exactly how this works for you. So just associate to a new company. We can add it in whatever company we want here. Actually, we have some very significant subsidiaries here for Swift Otter, Target, and Apple too. Shocking. So you can add as many of those in there as you would like. Save and continue edit, and we are good to go. Now, you are probably very familiar with this feature to log in as customer. You cannot see it well because I've zoomed in this page. Click that login as customer link, jump over here to the front end, and want to quickly show you what this looks like. To be honest, you're not going to really see much difference here. Again, these companies are very siloed, and I think that's one thing that's important to call out. Is each company is its own unique entity. There is no hierarchy here for customers on the front end. However, there is this company switcher, and this is the most important thing that you can notice here. Company switcher, I can switch between Swift Otter and our shocking subsidiary, Walmart. Right here, we change the settings for Walmart. At the end of the day, these companies are very siloed, but it is the building blocks for you to implement a really significant expansion of B2B capabilities for your customers. Out of the box, it works great, and it's going to provide immediate value. Speaking of ways to expand this to create value for customers, there's a couple of immediate areas that will provide an even better experience for your customers. And the first one is to allow company administrators to see sub-account orders. Now, if we come back in here to the customer experience, this would be the administrator for a customer. We can see here we have roles and permissions. And we have our default user, and here under the default user role, which you can create as many roles, and that's part of the incredible power that Adobe Commerce brings to the table, is you can see view orders of subordinate users. This is actually a feature that we are developing here at Swift Otter, so you thus see the checkbox at this point. This is the type of conversation that needs to be had. Ultimately, there is some nuance with how this would be built, and the biggest being the permissions for who gets to see what, and potentially limiting visibility to specific companies, even through potentially tagging sub-companies to group management so you can manage groups of these sub-companies. But it also doesn't stop with orders. We then have quotes and quote templates, also key areas to think about. Another important area for expansion would be to allow company administrators to create their own sub-child accounts. Right now, you have to email the store admin in order to make this association, which means the child company probably has already created their account at this point, which creates further efforts for your team to try to manage. By allowing company administrators to create their own sub accounts or child accounts, this would further streamline efforts by your customer service or sales team to manage the needs of your customers. But before you just release this on your website, there is a bit of a process, and especially focusing here on the technical and the change management aspects that we really need to talk through. First, your development team will need to do this upgrade to the B2B extension version 1.5. Good news is this is a free upgrade, doesn't cost you anything, and it is a straightforward process on a vanilla website. But who has a vanilla Magento website? Almost no one that I know of. So your dev team should then take the time to review existing dependencies and identify the impact. Hopefully the impact is minimal, but a quality agency partner like us here at Swift Otter can quickly determine the level of effort that it will take to get you access to these new features. You'll want to review the design, as there's a couple of new front-end elements, that new company switcher, that could impact how things are rendered on the front end depending on the level of customization that you have. If you want this integrated into your ERP connection, Adobe has the REST API connection that's available, but it's going to have to be built out because I can almost guarantee it's not built into your ERP connection at this point. Of course, then you will follow through the normal code delivery processes. Hopefully you're using best practice systems like we have developed here at Swift Auto, where you are delivering out to a development environment, then out to a staging environment, doing all your testing on the staging environment, then getting out to a pre-prod where you're using almost production information, doing a final vetting, and then pushing it out to production. Additionally, this feature is only managed by the admin team. So the good news is you can start with zero impact to your customers. You can start making those associations. It's easy. Nothing changes for your customers. In fact, you still have to manually associate each customer to all the companies that they want to access, provided you haven't built an automation for that capability. So you can get started on making those associations right away to have this information tied together in the backend system for when you need it. But when you are ready to give access to your customers for multiple companies, in other words, the child accounts, then keep in mind, you will have to associate each customer manually to each relevant child account. Your sales team will have to handle this. There is no way to import these associations that I've seen thus far. So that's where a conversation will have to happen about making sure people know how this all ties together. And additionally, ensuring that you propagate and educate your customers as far as how to find what I consider that slightly obscure company switcher in the header, that they can easily find that and know how to navigate down to the child accounts, as well as ensuring that they understand how the propagation works between the parent and the child accounts, as well as the permissions not being shared throughout everything. So it's a fantastic feature, and it is now ready for you to tailor it to exactly what you need. You know, I hope you found this information helpful. We regularly send out this type of content via our ongoing newsletter, the Ecom Buzz. Feel free to sign up for that on our website. Our goal is to see you as an e-commerce manager wildly successful and just crushing the goals that you have been set in front of you. Take care.